At the beginning of 1945, all across Europe, people were on the move. They were on the run, on their way to the front, or being transported from one camp to the next. The situation of the war at this point was chaotic. In the west, the Allied forces, and in the east, the Red Army were moving ever closer to Germany's borders. In Berlin, the decision was made to clear a number of concentration camps and prisons. For most of the inmates, this was a death sentence. On this list of camps was also Sonnenburg, today Slonsk in Poland. Sonnenburg was an overcrowded prison where some 100 Luxembourg forced recruits were imprisoned. They had been sentenced to prison by German war courts.
We know through eyewitness accounts that conditions in the prison were horrible, especially in regards to hygiene, but also the general treatment of inmates. It was tough, and with the ongoing chaos, there was a certain nervousness. On the 30th of January, the Russians got within 35 kilometers of the prison, and the decision was made to exterminate the inmates, over 1,000 at a time. The 20-man strong execution committee from the SS was dispatched. They reached the camp on January the 30th and started the preparations for the executions.
The preparations took place openly, and most prisoners knew then what was coming their way.
Through witnesses, we know that the SS finished their preparations around 9 o'clock and then had dinner. The shooting started at 10 o'clock that day. A cold-blooded mass murder took place with 819 prisoners killed. Among them, 91 Luxembourgers. You have to imagine that the shootings went on until the next morning, the 31st of January at 2 o'clock. When the deed was done, the situation was very chaotic. There was not room for the bodies to be disposed of.
Systematic mass murder happened at several sites over the last months of the war. Sonnenburg was liberated 2 days after the grueling night. A Russian cameraman took these pictures of the camp, images which were later used to prove war crimes.
The camp itself was liberated on February the 2nd by the Russian army. They found 4 survivors. 2 had hidden before the shooting and had stayed in their hideouts throughout. The other 2 had managed to stay alive, buried under a heap of corpses in the cold and the snow.
The massacre at Sonnenburg was the biggest of its kind for Luxembourg citizens, and it is remembered every year.
For the forced recruits, Slonsk remains a site to remember all the young people who fell or disappeared on the Eastern Front, who have not been recovered to this day. Slonsk stands representative of all those who fell or disappeared on the Eastern Front.
Stellvertretend für die Jungen, die eben am Osten gefallen oder verschwunden sind.